with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and I love it when you guys send me questions. Thank you so much. Just remember, if you are sending me PHI or anything like that, I am not answering your question because that is practicing out. Yeah, no, you're not my patient. So, but I'm glad to answer theoretical questions, no problem. So I got a really great educated question. And by the way, if you send me spammy or rude messages, I'm gonna delete them or block them. I'm not even going to deal with you. But this was obviously an orthodontist, a smart orthodontist, just sent me this 39 minutes ago. And he's asking about why do I mention power chaining on NiTi a little bit more? And I realized I didn't have this video, you know? Why do I say it's okay to power chain on NiTi? And why do I prefer power chaining on NiTi? And it's really whatever works in your hands. And I realize there are some really old school research out there that say it's better. There's better sliding mechanics in stainless steel. That's why you should power chain on stainless steel. And yes, in residency, we all power chained on stainless steel. But then there were a few really smart precepting, highly successful orthodontists who had amazing outcomes in their practices. And that's kind of how we learned who to follow and who not to trust in residency. We had a bunch of people who were just academians, and they just went off the research and their outcomes were awful whenever they told us to do things. So we stopped trusting them and we started trusting the people who could, you know, efficiently get from A to B in an efficient amount of time in a healthy way without causing damage, getting a great outcome. And one of them told us, that's bullshit. I power chain on NiTi all the time. So then I said, okay, well, if he can do it, I can do it. So basically what I remember him telling me over 20 something years ago was just make sure you work through your wire sequence, level and align, do your repos, take your progress panel, make sure your roots are all upright before you move into a heavier rectangular NiTi wire, fill the slot as much as you can. You know, power chain, if you're an 018 slot, you're going to power chain on 1825. If you're 022 slot, power chain on 1925, you know, NiTi, and make sure your roots are parallel. Make sure the wire is super level. Everything should be like money. Level and align should be done. All you're doing is power chaining to finish. That's all you're doing. Your transverse is corrected. Everything else is done. You can't go wrong. Maybe it goes a tad faster in stainless steel. I have personally not noticed any difference. As a matter of fact, I have more issues in stainless steel. First of all, it's a whole nother wire you have to get to. And a lot of times when your staff is trying to shove a stainless steel in, if it's not ready, they end up breaking brackets, okay? Also, the other problem I have with stainless steel is that even if you do manage to get it in, great, you know, we have a nice shiny glossy wire that supposedly has better sliding mechanics. Unless your patient is the most compliant person in the world, all it takes for them is to bite on one rock, one candy, one nut, one pizza crust, one taco shell, one chip, one flaming Takis, one hot Cheeto, and they will put a dent in that stainless steel wire. It can be, same thing goes with beta tie. It can be bent. And when it bends, the tooth bends with it. And now you get the joy of going back to a 16 NiTi, to an 18 NiTi, to an 1825 NiTi, to a 1925 NiTi, to the stainless steel, 5 wires, 5 months to fix that divot. If I stay in the very fully expressed 1825, 1925 NiTi, it doesn't happen because there's some flexibility in it, some give and take. And you know what? I never love the idea of something so rigid being on the teeth because that's not the way teeth are meant to be. They're meant to have some give and take, and that's why I've always liked NiTi. Maybe beta tie is a happy medium. It doesn't tend to bend as much. But yeah, that's pretty much my answer here and why I power chain on NiTi personally, but it's whatever works in your hands. And yeah, if you're like Mr. Research Nerd and you only go by the research, fine, do it. Nothing wrong with it. I think you're going to just find that it takes more time and it causes more trouble.